Nearly 100 firefighters from 5 suburbs fought the blaze at Burnsville High School. The first police officer on the scene described seeing a ball of fire break out windows in front of the school. Most of the fire was contained to the school's main lobby and adjacent hallways, but there's smoke damage just about everywhere.
In the front of the school, the flame extended into the second floor and the roof.
Far worse than I anticipated.
Principal Howard Hall says he's in a state of shock. He's been principal here for 22 years.
I didn't know what to expect, but this just has to exceed my worst expectations and my worst fears.
It seems that no part of the building was left untouched by the smoke and soot, including these student lockers that are caked with the stuff, and presumably the contents in the lockers are also damaged because of the vents. And to give you some idea of the intensity of the blaze, take a look at this. This used to be the plastic skylight up on the roof. It now looks like a giant piece of taffy.
Fire investigators from ATF, the State Fire Marshal's Office, and Burnsville Fire are all investigating. They say the fire appears to have started on the first floor, and they have evidence someone broke into the school through a door shortly before the fire erupted.
We can't say 100% at this point the fire set. Until we finish the complete investigation, we won't know that.
But you do know somebody broke into the building?
Yes, we do.